What is a tithi? Is it astrological or is it astronomical? Let's try to understand this ancient Indian concept in the next few minutes. In the Hindu calendar system, a divasa is measured from sunrise to the next sunrise. This in astronomy is called a solar day. Unlike a divasa, a tithi is a much different and intricate concept. In astronomical terms, a tithi is nothing but a lunar day. So how is it measured? To calculate a tithi, the speed of the moon relative to the sun is calculated. To calculate this, we have to subtract the sun's speed relative to the earth from the moon's speed relative to the earth. The moon takes approximately 27 days to complete one revolution around the earth, in which it completes a 360-degree circle. Hence, the moon's speed relative to the earth is 360 by 27, which is approximately 13 degrees per day. In a geocentric system, the sun takes 365 days to cover one revolution around the earth, in which it completes a 360-degree circle. Hence, the sun's speed relative to the earth is 360 by 365, which is simply 1 degree per day. So finally, the moon's speed relative to the sun is obtained as 13 minus 1, which is 12 degrees per day. This means that the moon moves ahead of the sun in the sky by 12 degrees every day. So this gain of 12 degrees per day by the moon over the sun on the ecliptic longitude is called a tithi. In the Hindu Amavasyanta calendar system, a month is measured between two successive Amavasyas, which means the month starts with the new moon and ends with the successive new moon. At the time of Amavasya, the east-west distance between the sun and the moon is absolutely zero. So as per the above calculation of the tithi, the moon moves ahead of the sun in the sky by 12 degrees till the next day. So this is the first 12 degrees gain of the moon over the sun from Amavasya, and it is called as Pratipada, which literally means the first step. On the next day, the moon is 24 degrees away from the sun on the ecliptic longitude, and hence it is called Dvitiya, and the cycle continues. Thus, when the moon and the sun are 180 degrees apart, it is called a Purnima, which means a full moon. And when the moon and the sun are 0 degrees apart on the ecliptic longitude, then it is an Amavasya, which is the new moon. So in a Hindu calendar month, there are a total of 30 tithis between two successive Amavasyas. 15 tithis are in the waxing fortnight called as Shukla Paksha, and 15 tithis in the waning fortnight or the Krishna Paksha. But this calculation is quite complicated for a layman to keep a track of. Hence, a simpler thumb rule was established so that even a layman could know the tithi of the day. The thumb rule stated that the running tithi during the sunrise of that day is simply the tithi of that day. So if the moon was in Tritiya during today's sunrise, then today's tithi would be Tritiya. But sometimes it so happens that the same tithi is repeated for two consecutive days. And sometimes it also happens that a certain tithi is skipped between two consecutive days. So the answer to this riddle lies in the motion of the moon around the earth. The moon revolves around the earth in an elliptical orbit. So at a certain point of time in its orbit, it is closest to the earth. And this point is called as the perigee. Whereas sometimes it is farthest from the earth. And this point is called as apogee. So as per the Kepler's law of planetary motion, the moon's speed is faster than the average speed when it is at perigee, and its speed is slower than the average speed when it is at the apogee. And this has an effect on the tithis. So let us suppose that during the sunrise of 7th of July, the moon was in Tritiya. Then as per the thumb rule mentioned earlier, the tithi for 7th of July is also Tritiya. But now let us assume that on 7th of July, the moon is at the apogee position, that is farthest from the earth. Hence, its speed will be slower than the average speed. And thus, the moon takes more time to cover the distance of Tritiya and enter into Chaturthi. So as a result of this, the moon enters Chaturthi after the sunrise of 8th of July. But during the sunrise of 8th of July, the moon was still in Tritiya, and hence as per the thumb rule, even on 8th of July, the Tithi of the day is treated as Tritiya. Therefore on 7th and on 8th of July, the same Tithi is repeated, and such a circumstance is called as a Tithi Vruddhi. Now let's take the other case. What if on 7th of July, the moon was at the perigee, that is closest to the earth? This would imply that the moon is faster than its average speed. So the moon is now going to cover Chaturthi during 7th of July and it enters into Panchami before the sunrise of 8th of July. So as per the thumb rule, during the sunrise of 8th of July, the running Tithi was Panchami and hence the Tithi for 8th of July is Panchami, whereas on 7th of July it was Tritiya. The Chaturthi is skipped between 7th and 8th of July, and this is called a Tithi Kshaya. So to summarize, Tithi is purely astronomical and it is simply the 12 degree per day gain of the moon over the sun on the ecliptic longitude. A Tithi Vruddhi occurs fundamentally when the moon is at apogee, and a Tithi Kshaya occurs fundamentally when the moon is at perigee. So if you found this video informative, then share it with your followers and help us to spread the truth about the ancient Indian culture to as many people as we can. And make sure you check out our next video on Nakshatra and ancient Indian calendar. Stay tuned, stay educated, and last but not the least, know your culture by self-investigating the truth. Shubhaste Panthanaha Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Da 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 da